Good morning, students. Myself, Arshdeep Kaur, a member of Shivjyoti Educational Group, Kota. I hope so, students, you all are safe and well at your home, and I pray for your wellness. So, students, today I am here to start with you one poetry of your first flight book. The name of the poem is The Ball Poem. So, students, let us begin with the poem, The Ball Poem. As the name denotes you that this poem is related with a ball. A young boy just lose his ball in a harbor, and he is just weeping out with it that why my ball is lost, what will I do? He goes into a dilemma that all my memories have gone with this particular ball only. But the poet makes him to realize that it is a life and you have to move on. The poet understands the feeling of the boy that it is a ball which is related to his childhood. But at the same time, he just tells him that sometime or the other, you might lose something or something might be stolen. So you have to move with the flow. So now let us see about the poet. What does the poet want to say? John L. Bremen was born on October 25, 1914. He was an American poet and a scholar born in McAllister, Oklahoma. He was a major figure in American poetry in the second half of the 20th century and was considered a key figure in the confessional school of poetry. His best known work is The Dream Songs. So we will begin with the poem now. Let us start with it. This poem is about losing something that you love dearly and learning to get over the pain of losing it. This is very important line, student. In this poem, the poet just wants you to learn losing is a part of life. You cannot hold anything. You love your dear ones, you love your things, but sometime or the other we lose it. So we have to get over that pain and move on in life. The poem talks about the experience in the life of a little boy who is feeling the grief at the loss of a much loved possession, his ball. So over here, a little boy has going through a loss. The grief is there in his heart of losing his favorite ball. This experience is painful for the boy as he has possessed it for a long time and he is learning to deal with the grief and overcome it. Now what happens? Why the boy is not able to overcome the grief? The boy has got this ball when he was very young. So he has gained a lot of memories with it. The losing of the ball was so hard for him to intake that he cannot think of losing it. And now he is learning that how he should overcome the loss of losing something in life, and he learned it in this poem. So let us see what happens. In the last few lines, the poet describes how the spirit of the boy, like the ball, is plummeting into the dark waters of the harbor. Now this boy is really getting sad that my ball has gone into the dark waters. He thinks that this ball will never come, although the poet also knows that he could bring a new ball. It is not so much costly, but the actual thing was, it is not about a ball. It is about the emotions and the feelings that is attached to the ball. He has got so much of memories in it. So he is just drawing down with the grief of losing that ball. As it drifts further, the boy learns to grow up and the part of him that is linked to the ball grow up as well until he is no longer a little boy. Now the poet says, as and when you grow up, with time we learn out the things, how to get over our emotional attachments with humans and with things. It happens, students, that we lost something. It might be any pen, any copy, or any person also that is attached to us. But is that the end of life? No. We have to learn to get over it. As we grow up in life, we learn such phases. Similarly, the boy also learns it, how to grow up, and with the learning phase of life, he learns to get away from the griefs of losing it. Let us come to the critical analysis of the poem. To others, the loss of a ball is of minor consequence, and we can think of buying another one. For us, what is it? A minute ball. So what if the boy lost a ball? He could buy a new one, right? But for him, it was not a ball. It was his childhood memories that was attached to it. However, for the boy, it was more than loss of ball. It was not just a ball, but it personifies his young days and happy innocence. With the ball, his innocence was attached. His younger child memories were attached. In this world, people will take balls just as they will take away our innocence and force us to grow up. So this is an important line, student. In today's world also, people snatch away the things from us. Like they snatch away the balls and we are left all alone. But we have to grow with it. We have to learn that if our innocence is gone, still we will have to live. And once we lose this innocence, we can never get it back. Balls were lost always. The little boy and no one buys a ball back. It will lose always, and you can buy it, but the emotions attached to it could not be buy. It is lost, and you have to believe that you cannot do anything for it. I hope so. You have understood the poem. The poet feels that money cannot buy us love, nor can it bring back what we had loved and lost. Money will not make you buy the emotions and the love and the loss of that love. This poem drives home the fact that quite often in life, we will be forced to do things unwillingly and we will lose things that we love. But irrespective of all this, we have to learn to stand up, be strong, and move on in life. We need to foster ourselves in a way that we are capable of letting things go and accept the flow and the life, welcome what it is to come. Now, over here the poet is saying, sometimes we do things that are done and forced to be done by us, which are unwillingly done. But this is only life. We have to learn that and accept and move on with the flow of life. That is the time when we learn to grow up and just mingle with the things. With the attitude, we won't just survive, rather we'll live a happy life. The poet uses imagery when describing how the ball personifies the spirit of the boy's childish innocence. Now over here, the poet is saying, you need to imagine what was the loss that the boy was suffering through. Let us see the theme of the poem. The ball poem is a poem with the theme of losing something that you love and treasured. You have loved it, you have created memories with it, so it is your treasure. If it is lost, we need to learn to get over and let go of it. We cannot do, if the thing is lost, we cannot get over it, but we have to move on with it. This loss can be in the form of a friend or a loved one, or it can be the loss of some golden, precious years of one's life. It could be anything. If you lose some dear one, or if you lose the life of some person, that life should be gone or move on, and it should be done. So students, as I told you that we would be marking the internal questions, so I request you everyone to come to page number 46 of your book, The First Flight, the ball poem. So students, as I told you that we would be marking the internal questions, it would be in the form of poetic devices. So kindly come to page number 46 of your book, The Ball Poem. In this, kindly mark the poetic device, repetition, in the first two lines. What is he to do? The second poetic device is personification, merely bouncing down the street. The third poetic device is metaphor. You just come to the line number 6th, last 6th line, that is balls will be lost always. This is your metaphor. So these were some of the poetic devices of your poem, The Ball Poem. Thank you. Students, let us see the syllabus that has been reduced from your books in the literature part. First of all, we'll see for the book First Flight, how to tell wild animals. Second is trees. Third, Majipal the otter. Fourth, For Any Chowdhury. Next book, Footprints Without Feet. The book and the chapter deleted are The Book That Saved the Earth, A Question of Trust, and the last is The Midnight Visitor. So students, I hope so you have understood the poem in a well manner. What does the poet want to convey us? The idea and the theme of the poem, that was, whatever happens in our life, we should learn to let it go and move it on. The loss is up and down, but you have to go with the flow. This is only life, that is taught us by the poet. Thank you.